the question of why contingent things exist, or why objects actualize potential, or whether infinite causal chains are possible, or whether humans have intrinsic dignity and moral responsibility. These are not scientific questions where we're just waiting on processing computers in order to figure out the answers. They are philosophical questions that we can know the answer to based on things like metaphysical, modal, and ethical reasoning. And when we reason in the correct way, those questions lead us to the conclusion of the existence of an infinite, purely actual foundation of all reality, God. But God is not a thing in the universe we detect using scientific instruments. God especially is not a bearded man hanging out in the universe somewhere. God is the ultimate foundation of reality. God is the infinite act of being itself.
God is the unconditioned source of existence itself. God is the sheer act of to be itself. God is not one being among many. God is the sheer act of being as such. Which means that holding any of these finite sort of figures, these mythological characters, to be God is just sort of silly once you understand what serious people mean by the word God.
Christianity takes us through tragedy to beyond tragedy, by way of the cross, to victory in the cross.
Meaning
that the cross is victory out of defeat. What the Christian gospel is a transvaluation of value, something you cannot anticipate in this world, in this history, but it empowers the powerless. What do you mean by power in the powerless? That's what God is, power in the powerless.
God is great.
Is it that simple?
God is great. Don't get no simpler than that, bro. You can know it all you want, but until you got to pick up that cross that you can't carry, and he picks it up for you and carries you and the cross, then you know.
You know, you might not believe in God, but God believes in you. It's not a battle you can win.
Being called upon to prophesy, to be a servant, to be an instrument, even to be a weapon, is something that we share, is a call to which we must all respond.
And the more and more I lean into God and work for God, the more wins God is going to bestow on our team.
The call is often seen as a moment of deep isolation. It is to be called out of the group, to have something special in particular conferred upon you. It is also seen finally as a kind of surrender, a way of embracing the sense of oneself as instrument, vessel, who bears and does God's will.
When you get out of this boring preoccupation with your own desires and your own autonomy, and you trust, you learn to trust in a power already at work in you that can do infinitely more than you can ask or imagine. That's faith. It'll heal you. Trust me. It'll heal you.
Listen to his voice. Do not be afraid.